cheater. Hello, my name is Christo Vladimirov Habachev. I was born on June 13, 1935 and died on May 31, 2020. When I was 84 years old, I am an artist and project designer. From a very young age, I have shown my talent as I made drawings of the fine art of Sofia. Where my mother worked as a secretary, when I was a young, I loved the theater and all the works of William Shakespeare.
Hello! My name is Jean-Claude Tinat de Guillebon. I was born on June 13, 1935, and I died on November 18, 2009, in New York, when I was 74 years old, because of a brain aneurysm.
In November 1958, I met Jean in Paris when I was commissioned to paint a portrait for her mother, Mrs. Priscilla de Guillebon.
I married Philippe Plachon, but on the honeymoon, I abandoned my husband and ran away with Christo, a decision not very well received by my parents, who were upset by Christo's tough financial situation. Being with Christo, we had a son named Cyril, who was born on May 11, 1960. We were very happy and we worked together forever.
I started drawing, painting, sculpture, and architecture course at the academy and visiting Czechoslovakia. I got to know the works of Picasso and Miró, accompanied by my notebook and a pencil where I drew many works of art.
I studied in France to be a flight attendant. My financial situation was good, and my parents sent me to travel around Europe, but I always liked art.
In 1960, I was living in Paris. I moved through the suburbs of the industrial zone in the garage of my great friend, the artist Jean Boss, because I need a large place, and there I found a jar for recycling used oil drums. It was then that I found my true passion, create large scale works.
Chris and I living together in the month of July. We inaugurate our first exhibition at the Harrow Gallery without the support of other artists. We rely some package in the docking area and some stake oil barrels. Thus, when the idea came up to create an environmental and temporary outdoor art project with rolls of oil and paper barrel wrapped with canvas and rope.
In Paris, I built a wall of oil barrels that block Rue Visconti, one of the narrowest streets in Paris. Illegally, and as a reason for only exhibition.
During the Chris exhibition at the Jay Gallery in Paris, Chris showed for the first time his project, the Rapid Public Building, and an art critic, Pierre Frestoni, called Chris the architectural visionary of the new realism.
We are a myriad of artists who have been inspired by land art with our large-scale works inspiring the architecture of cities such as Miami, Sydney, Kansas, Berlin, and New York.
We choose an artist's career away from protect museums. We like natural, and our technique is to hide or wrap public objects from oil barrels to museums. Our land art technique of contemporary art consists of a relationship in which the landscape and the art world are closely related, and our only material is natural itself.
In 1959, I changed my focus to grab objects, and instead of adorning the material with glue and sand, I keep it in touch.
In 1964, we moved to New York, and although we were poor because of our poor knowledge English language, Chris exhibited his work in several galleries, and we began to grab shop windows that helped us finance our debts and artist project.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
See you next time.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.